Yay.
Building a satellite, it turns out, requires hope.
Fingers crossed.
And a lot of patience. This is a model of SkyCube and how big it will be, 10 centimeters all around. But while the model's insides theoretically work, the real thing is actually being built now. Today's exercise, getting the radios, one of which will be in space, the other back on Earth, to talk to one another. One attempt.
I've got the guys building it. Oh God, please let it work.
After another.
I'm not even sure. Let me pull cables one at a time.
And another.
I guess it sounds like there's a couple of problems that aren't really fixable today. One of the radios is dead. I kid you not. It's supposed to
say. He said he tested them.
Soon proves it's going to be more difficult than originally thought.
You're buying me lunch. Yeah, you're buying me lunch now. Yeah.
But SkyCube's mastermind is undeterred.
We need to have our satellite built and manifested and delivered by September of this year. And in terms of financing, well, we've already booked the launch. The first deposit has been paid. A lot of the things that have to happen are already underway. We are a tiny bit behind schedule, but not much.
Once the cube is up and broadcasting messages from space, eventually it has to come back down. That's where the plastic sheeting comes in. 3 weeks of inflation will draw the satellite back down to Earth, as well as create a visible white streak across the sky.
Tim says it's going to be about a zero magnitude event, which makes it about as bright as the brightest stars in the sky.
The cube must be finished this fall. That's why time is precious, and getting components to work correctly matters to the whole team. When they finally force one another to pack up for a 3 o'clock lunch break.
We got the CPU board talking to a couple of cameras. That's nice.
Not everyone is willing to quit for the day.
Chris has decided he wants one more stab at the radio. He's not gonna come to lunch. He can't quite give up yet.
From Menlo Park, California, Carrie Davis, IDG News Service.